Hi, it's me, Dr. Prasad Puthilam. On my YouTube channel, My Intuition, offering free as well as entrance coaching classes on chemistry. This class is class number 5, Structure of Atoms. Here I'm explaining about the classical physics and modern physics, the difference between those two, and the three failures of classical physics which introduced the modern physics. So classical physics, most usually the classical physics refers to the 19th century physics. Even now, the classical physics, their concepts are often used when modern theories are unnecessary or complex for a particular situation. So classical physics, also called classical mechanics, that is applicable for the size which is larger than that of nano size, that is 10 to the power minus 9 meter, or if the speed of the matter, it is less than that of speed of light, that is 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. On increasing the on decreasing the size, when it reaches below nano size or below less than that of 10 to the power minus 9, classical mechanics won't work properly. Therefore, quantum mechanics or modern physics are required. Even if the speed of light goes near to or speed of matter goes near to the speed of light, that is 10 to the power 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second, then relativity mechanics and work both followed by quantum field theory. The modern physics usually referred to as 20th century or 21st century physics. Modern physics includes that of quantum theory and relativity, mainly whenever it is applicable. There are three main failures to classical physics. The first one is with the black body radiation. As per classical physics, you know that as the frequency increases, the energy is also increasing. Okay, so from radio wave to microwave, and when it goes to gamma ray, the frequency is increased, wavelength is decreased, frequency increased, then energy also increasing. That is as per the classical physics concept. And that is what's true. But therefore, we can say that as frequency is decreasing, the energy will be increasing. Okay, so whereas with the black body radiation, the energy of black body radiation is not shared evenly by all frequencies of light. You can say that it depends upon temperature. On decreasing the frequency, you can say that at 4000 Kelvin, at 5770 Kelvin, which is the surface temperature of sun, as well as at around 7000 Kelvin, all this shows that there is a deviation from classical physics, because as per classical physics, this should not happen. There should not be decrement here. Okay, so the second failure is with the photoelectric effect. That means when light shines on a surface of a metallic substance, the electron on the metal absorb the energy of the light, and it can escape, the electrons can escape from the metal surface. That phenomenon is known as photoelectric effect. As per classical physics, if the energy of light or the light intensity is very low, then it will take a time for the electron to absorb the light waves, then emits the electron. But the experiment shows that if light of certain frequency can eject electron from a metal, it makes no difference how dim the light. That means there is never a time delay happened. But as per classical physics concept, there should be a time delay. So that is a second failure. The third failure is to explain the hydrogen atom, stability of atoms, as well as the line spectra given by hydrogen atom mainly gives three colored spectra. Classical physics are not able to explain it in detail. Okay, so because of the orbiting electron in atom constantly changing the direction, and as the direction changes or as the velocity changes, there will be acceleration, and that acceleration of charged particle should emit electromagnetic radiation or light. As a result, when the electromagnetic radiation is emitted by the electron, or light waves are emitted by electron should be continuously losing energy. So when it loses energy, it should spiral out, or it should fall to the nucleus, and the physics, the calculation as per the classical physics says that it takes only 10 to the power minus 8 seconds for an atom to collapse. Okay, so this is the representation. The electrons loses energy and should finally should go to the nucleus within 10 to the power minus 8 seconds, but it is not happening. Therefore, All these three mainly are the failures of classical physics. It is not a failure of physics. Only the concepts based on the 18th and 19th century scientists, what they proposed, that made us to the modern inventions, which we call as the modern physics. So physics never failed. It is a improvement only happened. So thank you very much for watching my video. The next video covering the detail about the dark black body radiation, photoelectric effect, as well as the hydrogen spectra or hydrogen atom, its stability. So once again, thank you very much. Please do share my YouTube channel, subscribe my YouTube channel and support. Have a nice day.